Hi dear friends, today we shall discuss a novel called The English Teacher, which is prescribed for the BA 4th semester students of Rani Chennamma University, Belagavi. The writer of the novel is R.K. Narayan, whose full name is Rashipuram Krishnaswamy Narayan Swami, was born in the year 1906 and died in the year 2001. He is one of the finest Indian authors of his generation writing in English. He is credited with bringing Indian literature in English to the rest of the world and is regarded as one of India's greatest English language novelists. His stories were simple, fictional, and celebrated the humor and energy of ordinary life. He is one of the greatest trios of Indian writing in English. They are Mulk Raj Anand, Raja Rao, and R.K. Narayan. It was he who brought Indian culture or Indian ethos, Indian customs into English and popularized India at international level. His works and achievements are, he has written some 34 novels. Best among them are The English Teacher, Waiting for the Mahatma, The Guide, The Man Eater of Malgudi, The Vendor of Sweets, A Tiger for Malgudi. He also published short versions of prose, version of two Indian epics, The Ramayana and The Mahabharata. He got Sahitya Academy Award for The Guide in the year 1958. He got Padma Bhushana Award in the year 1964 for writing in English. He was nominated for the Nobel Prize in Literature multiple times. He was also nominated to the Rajya Sabha in 1989. The present novel, The English Teacher, was published in 1945. It is third of the trilogy, which comprises Swami and Friends, The Bachelor of Arts, and The English Teacher. The novel was republished in 1953 under the title Grateful to Life and Death. The novel is autobiographical in its approach. It is a series of experiences in Krishna's life. The novelist brings about joys and sorrows of Krishna's life. And the novel recounts the journey towards achieving inner peace and self-development. The important characters of the novel are Krishna, the English teacher, who works at Albert Mission College, Malgudi. As English teacher, he teaches to the BA first year and second year students. He handles optional English papers. The second character is Susila. She is Krishna's wife and she is a housewife. And the third character is Leela, who is daughter of Krishna and Susila. And the fourth character is the headmaster. The headmaster of the school in which Leela learns, or so to say, it is a kindergarten or a nursery, which is run by the headmaster. It is a kind of Gurukula school wherein students are given full freedom to learn whatever they want. They are learnt by playing and they are learnt by doing experiments. The next characters are Doctor and Swami. Doctor, who attends Susila, represents the English culture, and the Swami, who makes Krishna to communicate with his dead wife, represents Indian culture, Indian superstitions, Indian beliefs, Indian customs. Next, we shall discuss the autobiographical elements in the novel. First of all, I will tell you how it is related to R.K. Narayan's life. Narayan's wife name was Rajamma. She also died of typhoid at an early age. which deeply affected R.K. Narayan. In the novel, Krishna's wife Susila died of typhoid after 5 years of marriage. Narayan was concerned for their daughter Hema, who was only 3 years old. In the novel, Krishna too was worried about Leela's upbringing and her schooling. Narayan was obsessed by the thought of communicating with his dead wife, and Krishna also is obsessed to communicate to his dead wife. Knowledge and appreciation of English literature. In real life, R.K. Narayan was very much interested in English literature, and he was behind English knowledge. In the novel, Krishna is an English teacher and he loves English literature, and he is very much interested in gaining knowledge about English. Distaste for teaching uninterested Indian students. In real life, R.K. Narayan was not interested in teaching English literature to Indian students who are uninterested in learning English literature. In the novel also, we can see how Krishna is not interested in teaching Indian students the English literature. Next, we shall see that the novel is an expression of under colonial rule. There is a communication of colonial rule in the novel. We shall see how it is. The title itself suggests the influence of the unwelcome British ruler. The title of the novel, the English teacher itself says that it is an encounter of East-West. By the end of the novel, Krishna realizes that his profession as an English teacher is worthless. And Krishna, by the end of the novel, comes to conclusion that the profession which he is doing is not worth. And there is a passage by which we can understand how Krishna was not liking his job. I quote, "I could no longer stop Shakespeare and Elizabethan metre and romantic poetry for the 100th time into young minds. This education had reduced us to a nation of maroons. We are strangers to our own culture and camp followers of another culture, feeding on leaves and garbage." Wherein Krishna says that, I unquote, Krishna says that stopping the students with Shakespeare and Elizabethan romantic poetry is not useful. We are becoming slaves in the hands of English people. And he also is very much concerned that we are not teaching our own culture, rather we are teaching English culture to our own students. There is also another theme called predictability to unpredictability in the novel The English Teacher. Krishna is aroused from his predictable life at school to the unexpected news that his wife and child are coming to join him. We can see how Krishna is unpredictable when he listens, when he learns that Susila and Leela are coming to join him in Malgudi, and he is very much worried how they could get off from the train and how Leela could be brought down without making any injuries. Susila's unpredictability. She gets struck in a contaminated laboratory and becomes ill. Doctor's prediction that Susila will get well also is not realized. The doctor says that Susila will recover, but Susila doesn't recover and she dies ultimately. Next, we shall see how the novel discusses the East-West encounter. There is coexistence of Western and native cultural attitudes in the novel. Susila is treated by a doctor and by Swamiji. The doctor represents Western scientific or rational world, whereas the Swamiji represents mystical method of healing of Indian culture. Juxtaposition of English and native cultures. There is a juxtaposition of English and native cultures in the novel. For example, the street where the headmaster lives is Anderson Street, but the street is very poor in sanitation, with wild people and wild children. Western intellectual frame of mind to native Indian spiritual practice. There is a communication with the spirit of his departed wife. Even though Krishna is an English teacher, he tries to follow a mystical method of talking with the dead people, which is very much in practice in our Indian culture. Thank you very much. In next lesson, we shall discuss the first chapter of the novel. Thank you.